Should be somewhere around there, I'm guessing.
Right. Yeah, good. Thank you.
Okay. Well,
use the button to brake or something like that. So that's really about it.
And in the event the train needs to be rescued, or if there's some sort of...
We'll sort that out when it happens.
If just take a bit of some plastic device.
Yeah,
we've got
all the stuff.
It'd be better with a steam engine. That would look funny, a steam engine rescuing a battery train.
Stranger things have happened. Okay.
You two are linked up, yeah? You know what you're doing?
Thanks to a real team.
I watched the
Thank you, thank you. Have you got a lint?
Oh yeah.
What's this maximum speed?
60.
60?
Yeah. We can do more if the batteries are de-restricted. We could do about 100. So.
The traction's running.
Here's the batteries.
Yes,
and 5 miles per hour is completed. Now, this is a good thing as it allows us to demonstrate our train's impressive acceleration, and we'll be doing that very shortly.
I'm going to take a look at the concrete.
it.
And here you can feel the train's impressive acceleration. We're going away at 1 meter per second squared, and we can do that up to 40 miles per hour. This means that we can both see and human feet climbing into trains that are notionally faster than us. For example, a train with a top speed of 75 miles per hour can be slower across the whole of the route than ours with its top speed of 60 miles per hour, and it's simply because of our ability to accelerate so fast.
Through
even
there.
As the UK's smallest and newest train manufacturer, we need to move fast to keep ahead of the game, and this is why we built our battery train. We wanted to prove that battery technology can work on today's lines and provide clean green solutions where needed. This train can achieve a range of 40 miles between charges, and that's a conservative estimate using today's battery technology. We know that this is going to improve as rates of recharge improve as battery technology develops. The train, battery train, can also use overhead line or third rail where they're existing, and this means it can take advantage of existing electrification. But if not, we've also built and patented an automatic charging system, which we'll talk about later when we get back to the very next. And this can be installed easily at the end of the line. So the train can just pull up, connect, and get its charge straight from the charging system, and be off ready to go again in about 3 or 4 minutes.
Which is the battery and the genset. And the genset, or the diesel engine, charges the battery, so it basically extends the range of the vehicle. Well, if it's really low, about an hour.
No emissions
at all.
That was today.
Yeah, basically, it would have had motors originally via a gearbox to the axle. They would have been DC brush motors. Now they're brushless. So it's just for ease of maintenance. You also get better power as well.
The best in the training.
No. Still not too bad though.
Where you went down.
The force is
in the stretch of Long Welders Hill that we've got. There's a noticeable difference.
Yeah.
Over on the second boat side of the train, and the traffic area, just the boat.
Very small.
Thank you. That's not Jerry, that's it's the driver. No.
So it's usually a train failure, the doors won't open.
Oh, that's a normal train. I was coming there. Okay, sorry. Let me give you. That's all right.
Yeah, I don't see there's a problem.
I'm going to make it up.
Cheers.
Yeah, but I'm just remembering.
Yes, indeed. Yeah, come on. Well, that's, I'm going to have a chat to him.
Yeah. Thank you.